Another option to purchasing eyepieces is what is called a Barlow. A Barlow is essentially a tube here with a lens at the end of the barrel, and that magnifies the eyepiece that you're using in the telescope by a factor of 2 or 3, depending on the Barlow, 2 or 3 being the most usable. If you're wondering why you might use such a device, well, typically your telescope will come with at least 1 or 2 eyepieces of different focal lengths. This is a 12 millimeter eyepiece here, and if you can see, the lens we have to look through is not very generous, and it can be kind of difficult to find that sweet spot. So let's say this eyepiece gives me 200 magnification in the telescope I want to use. This eyepiece right here, with a much more generous lens, gives me 100 magnification when I put it in my telescope. And as you can see, that greater surface area on the lens there makes it easier for me to look through and easier to find that sweet spot. So in order for me to achieve the magnification that this eyepiece has but still keep that generous relief, I'm going to insert the Barlow. Here's the 2x Barlow. I'm going to put it inside the eyepiece here, or excuse me, inside the diagonal. I should take this lesson myself. And then the eyepiece goes into the diagonal. Now I've doubled the magnification of my eyepiece. Now this 100 magnification gives me 200 magnification, and it could be kind of a handy little tool to have. Again, I don't recommend more than a 2x Barlow. 200 magnification is a little bit high, but in order to save the price of another eyepiece and to get a little bit more generous eye relief, a good Barlow will run you about $100 and could be a good investment as well. Another fun accessory for eyepieces is called a Bino Viewer. For planetary and lunar work, these will absolutely spoil you. Well, the idea is to get input to both sides of the brain by getting the light to both eyes. When you have both eyes on the telescope here, 20 magnification, 50 magnification really seems to fill out more and give you that 3D effect. So a Bino Viewer is a way to essentially turn your big telescope into a binocular viewer. I've inserted the Bino Viewer here. It does take 2 eyepieces this time of equivalent focal lengths. I insert them into the Bino Viewer here. And just like a set of binoculars, as I approach the Bino Viewer, I adjust the inner pupillary distance by starting with them wide, and then I'll just bring them in until the two images merge and I see one sight. For me, I really love using the Bino Viewers on the Moon, on Saturn, on Jupiter. It really makes those guys pop a 3D effect. However, when you do get into deep sky objects, objects that are a little dimmer, a little harder to see, the benefits of a 2-inch eyepiece will become apparent. Because as of now, what you're doing is taking 1.25 inches of light, and Bino Viewers are 1.25 inches barrel, and splitting that into 2 eyes. So the brighter objects look really well. But if you're going to go for deep sky, for the dimmer objects, a 2-inch eyepiece lets in more light and will give you a better image.